Be among people that you can feel like you are family.
Well.
And that's the way it is here sometimes here at Second Mount Vernon. You know what families go through. It ain't always good, it ain't always bad, but it's family. Amen? Amen. Now, I want to start off with reading scripture from 2 Samuel. Mm-hmm. 2 Samuel chapter 6 verse 14.
All right.
Through 23. And when you're there with me, let me know by saying amen. Chapter 6, verse 14 through 23. Amen?
Amen.
That's right. And it reads, and David danced before the Lord with all his might. And David was girded with a linen ephod. So David and all the house of Israel brought up the ark of the Lord with shouting and with the sound of the trumpet. And as the ark of the Lord came into the city of David, Michal, Saul's daughter, looked through a window and saw King David leaping and dancing before the Lord. And she despised him in her heart. And they brought the ark of the Lord and set it in his place in the midst of the tabernacle that David had pitched for it. And David offered a burnt offering and peace offering before the Lord. And as soon as David had made an end of the offering, burnt offering, and peace offering, he blessed the people in the name of the Lord of hosts. And he dealt among all the people, even among the whole multitude of Israel, as well to the women as men, to everyone a cake of bread and a good piece of flesh and a flagon of wine. So all the people departed, everyone to his house. Then David returned to bless his household. And Michal, the daughter of Saul, came out to meet David and said, "How glorious was the king of Israel today, who uncovered himself today in the eyes of handmaids of his servants, as one of the vain fellows shamelessly uncovered himself." And David said unto Michal, "It was before the Lord." And David said unto Michal, "It was before the Lord which chose me before thy father and before all his house to appoint me ruler over the people of the Lord over Israel. Therefore, I will play before the Lord. And I will yet be moved by than thus, and will be based in my own sight, and of the maidservants which thou hast spoken of, them shall I be had in honor." Therefore, Michal, the daughter of Saul, had no child until the day of her death. My text this afternoon is going to be a subject, if you will. What's in there will come out.
All right.
Let us look to the Lord in prayer. Oh, Heavenly Father, most gracious God, who deserves all praise? Lord, we thank you. We thank you for this opportunity. Oh, we give you praise, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for the people that have come to hear a word from you. But Lord, we don't take it lightly. I thank you, Lord. I ask you, O God, to move me out of the way. And Lord, stand in the place for me. Whatever you give me, Lord, help me pour it out.
Yes.
I'm just a vessel.
Yes.
Lord, that
I
yield to be used by thee.
Yes.
I pray, Lord, for those that wanted to be here but couldn't come.
Yes.
Please bless and have mercy upon them.
Yes.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for the ones that are here.
Yes.
Oh, you're so awesome. Lord, we just humbly submit ourselves and our love, Lord, because we know we don't have nobody else but you.
Yes.
Lord, we don't have nobody else but you. We thank you. In the Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Everyone will, I want you to do something for me. I'm not going to be before you long. I want everyone to just stop what you're doing right now. And I want you to breathe in, and I want you to breathe out. I'm with you. In other words, you just inhale and exhale.
Well.
And that's also known as respiration.
Yeah.
Which also lets me know that you're not dead and you're living.
Amen.
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 Amen. how awesome God is.
Yeah.
Now, if you will, let's turn our attention to King David. David was also known as a man after God's own heart.
Yeah.
I said David was a man known after God's own heart. Allowing his feelings, his inner feelings, to come out when they had brought the ark back. And his wife, Michael, didn't quite understand that. She was, oh, it's coming out. It's coming out. Now, David was allowed, again, I say, his inner feelings to come out. And when he danced before the Lord, but you see, David had other reasons to dance too. God has been so good to David. And you all probably know something about that. If you ever have been in a position to be backed up against the wall and have things not going your way and you just needed God. And you had to call on him. And when you called and he gave you an answer, oh, glory to God. Sometimes you felt like praising him. Sometimes you would dance. Sometimes you would cry. Oh, glory to God. If anybody know what I'm talking about this afternoon. So I imagine it was a great joy for David. And sometimes we say, or there's a song that goes, I have a praise in my heart. I have a praise and I got to get it out. I could see David doing that. And he didn't worry about who was looking at him. It didn't matter at that time. Although David was the king. But it didn't matter at that time. Because David had something on the inside and he had to get it out. And it was surely coming out. And I'd like to pause right here and ask the question. Has anybody in here ever have a praise in your heart? Or maybe you have a praise this afternoon in your heart. And if you don't, let me tell you why you should have one. I think he woke you up this morning. I think you made it here. Some of you all even simmer downstairs and have a little fresh mint. You couldn't have did that without God. You couldn't have done that. Oh, glory be to God. Yeah, praise in the heart. Because God's goodness and mercy. Now, let's talk a little bit about Michael, David's wife, Saul's daughter. The Bible says she looked through a window and saw King David leaping and dancing before the Lord. And she despised him in her heart. In other words, she looked down on him, her king, her husband, and she looked down on him with contempt and scorn. What was in there was coming out.
Come on now.
Do any of you know about somebody maybe down, I'll say downplaying somebody sometimes? You know, we got some folks, they think they a little bit better than others. When God created us all, it don't matter. It don't matter. How high, it don't matter how low. God created us all. And that's what I love about him, because he loves us all. Whether we rich or whether we poor, God loves us. And remember, what's in there comes out. Can anybody acknowledge this afternoon, or should I say, I need a few true folks in here that can say sometimes you had something there when, so pleasant when it came out, like Michael. I said, are there any true folks in here that can acknowledge sometimes you had something there that wasn't so pleasant when it come out? I said, is there any true folks in here that has something on the inside that's not so pleasant when it come out. Well,
come on now.
Let me ask you this. How many of you gotten up sometimes at night and made your way to the restroom or walk around in the dark? You know, the power was just off not too long ago here, and you tried to move around and maybe you stomped your toe. Now what did you say? I thought I had some true folks. It'll come out. Glory be to God. Now back to Michael. Maybe you stood at your window and watched others that allowed things to come out. And what I'm talking about here is hate. What I'm talking about here may be hostility. What I'm talking about here may be hurt. What I'm talking about here may be doubt. Maybe what I'm talking about here might be envy. Sometimes it's frustration. Sometimes it's abuse. I'm talking about what's coming out. Sometimes, Lord, you think you might be doing the right thing. Something happening here, like I never felt before. Sometimes, oh glory to God, yeah. Oh, it's coming out. It's coming out. Oh, well, I want to know if you ever see somebody with that and it's coming out. What do you do when it comes out? Can you go to them?
Yes.
Can you talk to them?
Yes.
Can you pull out something out of you,
yes,
that will help them?
Yes.
Well, I thought I'd about to tell you this afternoon.
Yes.
If you don't have nothing in there,
yes,
when it comes out,
yes,
you better start this right.
Yes.
Anybody in here know what I'm talking about? joy.
Yeah.
I feel peace.
Yeah.
I feel love.
Yeah.
Oh, love.
Love.
Real love.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just like King David. I could just imagine him.
Yeah.
Think about what God had done.
Yeah.
And here you are, woman, trying to tell me.
Yeah.
What you trying to tell me?
Yeah.
I think about what the Lord has done for me.
Yeah.
Oh, it had to come.
September 2017.
Amen.
Minister Khaleelah.